with Luke Murphy, winning rider of today's first race, the four-year-old mare's maiden run with the Tides. It was her second run. Luke, she fell when she was going to be behind Jenny Flix of Colin Bowes, and you made the running today. You went a good gallop and she was very impressive.
She had a very good run the last day behind a nice filly of Colin Bowes. So she's unlucky to fall, and she's probably going to be a good second that day. So she would run under her belt. I was able to just make use of that and just kick on there. The lads said she was in great form since she ran. And it's nice. She picked up very well.
She did, and she's very good to jump as well.
Yeah, super. When I let her on now over the fort and the third last, just I gave her a squeeze in the belly and she had loads of scope. She went down and she's good and brave. Nice.
You wouldn't be a regular rider for Sean Doyle, so how did that come about today?
No, I'm not sure that some of the guys he has working from, they got injured and bits and pieces. Paddy Scallon, he broke his wrist here last week, and Jack Kendrick, he obviously got a bad fall in Tipperary there 2 weeks ago, so I was lucky now just to be there in the right place, I suppose. And
that's what it's about, isn't it?
That's what it's about.
And you're enjoying a great time of it. Here last week, then you had the double, so things are going well for you.
Yeah, it's really, look, it couldn't be going any better, but you can't do it without riding nice horses. You know, these nice four-year-olds for the likes of Denis Murphy or Sean, you can't go too far wrong when you're with those guys. So, very good now.
Many more today, Luke?
I think 1 5-year-old. He was second in Cork. He should go close now, hopefully.
Good, best of luck with that.
Thank you.
Well done, Bernice. You're here today representing your father, who can't be here because of his sleep. He was at the sales. We'll start with the sales, the coachman, who was an impressive winner in Tipperary, and he sold for a nice money at Tattersalls on Friday.
Yeah, he sold very well, thank God. 5-year-old, he's a big raw baby, so that's why he kind of kept him. He's a half brother to the Crillon, who won his bumper for us a couple of weeks previous. So that really boosted form as well, so we were delighted.
Good day today so far, a double on the cards, one more to run. Hidden Heroics, who Jamie Rhodes, very impressive, and obviously a lot of delight for you because you own this horse.
Yeah, I was absolutely pure delight. It makes a little bit of difference that I own him as well. Kind of the first one I had it, a bit of a squeaking. So it was brilliant. Got a great buzz out of it. Nice horse.
Your dad won't be looking for a percentage of him or anything now.
Oh, I'm sure he'll be looking. No, he's a very nice horse and we're delighted with him. Hopefully we'll get him sold now, maybe.
He'll go to sale probably.
Yeah, maybe. And we'll get another one, please, God.
Good. Loch Derrick Rocco then, who was ridden by Luke Murphy, who just won that race there, to give Luke a double on the day. Luke's riding very well.
Yeah, he's
really
brilliant, yeah.
Nice horse, this horse?
Yeah, the Scirocco, he wasn't beaten fire the last day. Just beaten by, I think it was not even 3/4 of a length or something.
Yeah.
We're delighted with him today. Just lacked that tiny bit of experience the last day and done it easy there today. Hopefully going to sell him now as well.
It's easy without your father running the show, is it?
Oh yeah. Simple, yeah. We'll keep going anyway.
Exactly. Listen, well done today with the double, most importantly with the horse that you own yourself.
Thanks a million, David. Thank you.
With Ian Donoghue, winning trainer of the 5-year-old mare's maiden, optional mix, and that's your first winner in your name, Ian. Congratulations, you must be delighted. Cheers. And on home turf here as well in Fairyhouse.
Cheers, David. Yeah, we're only 10 minutes from Fairyhouse here, so it's great to get it here.
And this is owned as well then,
it's
so it's a real special occasion, your fiancé.
So dinners will be cooked for a week, anyway.
You'll be well looked after. And Paul Bannon rode it, jumped out, made the running, and a good gallop the whole way.
Yeah, look, she's tough as nails. She could have went again, she just gallops, stays and gallops and jumps. She's a real honest mare.
You obviously fancied her today, she's a couple of good runs under her belt.
Yeah, we fancied her, she had a great run, bumper in Tipperary. She was third there behind a good mare, Gavin, so we really liked her coming here today.
How many have you got in at the minute?
We've 10 there right now that could run away. We worked 4-year-olds this morning, they're actually going on their holidays now, and we'll just tip away at them few older ones now for the rest of the season.
What's the plan? Obviously, trying as many winners as you can, but looking forward to next season then. You just build up the team to a bigger amount?
Yeah, build up kind of hopefully more quality than numbers. We always have room there for more, but we think we've a few nice 4-year-olds now for the autumn, so hopefully they can do the job for us.
He rode a double last year, I remember. So is that the riding career's over now? It's just training now, yeah?
Well, we were laughing this morning in the gallops. There's one I think I'll come back to ride her. I'll let the boys ride her. I'll ride her myself and then I'll retire officially after that.
Oh, it's fair play to you. And Paul Bannon and Joey Dunn, they'll ride?
Yeah, they'll ride the most of them. Look, Joey's great. I'm in Gavin's in the mornings with Joey and then any afternoon he comes home with me. And Bannon the same. He meets us at school and two boys help me out big style.
And so, your brother Keith, does he help out at all?
Yeah, Keith helps out. Now, the odd morning you might get him to ride work, but it'd be a struggle.
That's good. Well, listen, well done today, and I'm sure that's going to be the first of many.
Cheers, thanks, Davey.
Well done, Derek, winning today's last, the second divide of the 5-year-old Geldon's Maiden. Sir Jack Sherrell for Elmarie Holden, a yard who you have great success with. Long run from that second last, which was your last today because of the faller at the last. Think you're always going to win even with the last fence a minute?
Yeah, do you know what, he's a lazy bloke and he races kind of lazily, so I felt when he came under pressure and I asked him forward, he kept responding all the way to the line. I'd have preferred if the fence was in because he was jumping brilliantly. He's the most fabulous jumper, and I think that fence would have definitely made a bigger difference in the finishing distances. So nice performance, and he had the experience of a hard run. Unfortunately, I suppose from a sales point of view, having a hurdle run doesn't always help with the sales potential of a horse. But when we had no point of point racing, Elmarie decided to give him a run in the hurdle race. And it was a very credible run, the nab and hurdle now. He ran a cracker and then he's after coming back into this sphere and he's after winning. So that's a nice horse now and I'm sure he's going to win races. Yeah.
And he'll head to the sales now?
I'd imagine so. I'd chat to Elmarie and give her my opinion on the performance. And I think he's a nice horse to win races. And I think she'll decide then where she wants to go after that.
Good. Busy week ahead, Punchestown, the finale of the National Hunt season, and you have a busy week ahead. Two rides in bumpers on Tuesday in the opening day, one for Garoda Lachlan and one for Mags Mullins in the Goff's Land Rover bumper.
Yeah, busy week. It's possibly the best week of the year to be an amateur jockey. It's a wonderful week and Punchestown give us so many opportunities to race, right? If it's not bumpers, it's over the Banks course and then it's Hunter Chase and the Bishop's Cup. Punchestown are so good to amateur riders. It's the best week of the year to be an amateur rider.
And of course you ride for the man who's the king of the Banks horses and the Bulger, so it must be a couple of nice exciting horses to ride during the week.
Yeah, and do you know what, I'd walk around the Banks horse there on Friday, so I was riding work in the car on Friday and walked the Banks horse. It's in beautiful condition with a few new additions, a few new surprises going around there for jockeys. It's in great order, and it's a credit to the Punchestown team. Richie Galway, Conor O'Neill, they've done a wonderful job producing the track and they've been well watered, so I think we'll have safe.
Good. Well, listen, well done today and very best of luck in Punchestown.
Thank you very much.